morning. Praise the Lord. I said, God, you know, me and God, you know, sometimes we wrestle. I understand why people don't want to get a word. Because sometimes God can be a last minute God.
Yes.
But praise the Lord this morning. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. I'm just excited for what God can do. Hallelujah. And what he's doing. I thank God for the vein that he's in. I believe that the Lord is going to speak to you this morning. Hallelujah, about something that you've been dealing with and you've been wrestling with and that you need some resolution to in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord God, we bless you this morning and we give you praise, we give you glory, we give you honor. Lord, we're excited for what you're doing in others' lives,
yes.
Lord God. God, we rejoice with them, Lord God. Ha, shababa. Lord, we thank you, Lord God. Because, God, we know when it's our turn, they're going to rejoice with us, Lord God. Father God, we just thank you this morning that, Lord God, you anoint, Lord God, every heart, Lord God. Lord, we ask, Lord God, that you bless them that their heart will receive not from me, Lord God, but from heaven, Lord God. That what you're saying unto them, Lord God, that they will take it back, Lord God, that they will walk in their homes, Lord God, they will get in their cars, Lord God, and that the anointing would follow them, Lord God, and cause the blessings of heaven to overtake them and overflow in their lives.
Amen.
And Father God, we thank you today, Lord God. We bind the devil, we bind any spirit that's not like God, and we thank you for the angels being loosed in this place in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. God is a good God. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I just thank him. I'm so excited. Praise God for what he's doing. I know sometimes that our lives is filled with a lot of difficulty. Sometimes things are complex. Sometimes we have situations going on in our life. And, you know, I always ask God, I said, well, Lord, you know, I said, sometimes I want to go a different way, but this is the way the Lord led me to 2 Kings. We're going to be in 2 Kings today. Praise the Lord. Chapter 19. Praise God. And we're going to be looking at this because I believe God wants to speak to us about our situation out of this book today. Praise God. And I'm just going to tell you a little bit about the end, but what happened, Hezekiah had a problem. Hallelujah. He had received a letter, hallelujah, from the king of Assyria. And you know, when I was getting this together, praise the Lord told me, he said, you know, people been receiving mail. He said, they've been receiving papers, and praise God. And see, you know what? But then God began to speak to me about this, that today, hallelujah, that God gonna bring resolution. Hallelujah. He's gonna bring closure to those things that we've been getting. Because what Hezekiah did, even though the king had sent word to Hezekiah, we're not going to get ahead of the message, but praise God, God honored what he said, even though the king tried to tell him, don't you depend on your God.
Amen.
I'm telling you here today, don't you give up on God.
Amen.
Don't you, when they tell you, don't let your God deceive you, I'm here to tell you, God is working and turning some things around for you.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Now, let me take my time, praise God, because see, I know, hallelujah, I just want to put this out here right, because I want you to see that God is trying to talk to you today, because see, you got some difficult decisions, let me tell you, and sometimes, sure, we can go to other people, we can go to something, but sometimes Hezekiah had to take this thing directly to God. He had to take it directly to God. And if y'all go back and read 2 Kings, it'll tell you that Hezekiah, he really had went and paid tribute to this king, and he really shouldn't even went. That's why the Bible said you got to pray about everything you do.
Yes.
Because he said he really didn't owe the king, now he didn't really have to go, because the king wasn't even flowing right. But sometimes we say, well, because we're Christians, and sometimes people come to me and they tell me, well, Pastor, I'm too nice, and you know, I just feel like they're going to say I'm not a Christian if I don't do this. You better stand for something. If you're going to be on the Lord's side, be on the Lord's side. Sometimes God's not going to release you to go everywhere. Sometimes he's not going to release you to do everything. But anyway, but God still moved for for Hezekiah in this situation. Praise the Lord. So praise God. I want to go to 2 Kings. Hallelujah. And I want to start at verse 19. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Glory to God.
And I hope I didn't misprint my papers today.
Amen, amen.
Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. God is good. Amen. Amen. So praise God. It says, now the king heard concerning Tiarach, and I'm in 2 Kings chapter 19, verse 9.
Amen.
He says, behold, he has set out to fight against you. So he sent messengers to Hezekiah saying, thus shall you speak to Hezekiah, king of Judah. Do not let your God in whom you trust deceive you, promising that Jerusalem will not be given in the hand of King Assyria. You know, sometimes God will speak to us and the enemy will come back and tell us, now listen, they'll tell you, now look, we know what we're doing. This is the system. This is the way things go. We know protocol. We know policy. We know how this go now. You know the world tells you that. But then when God has told you something else, so King of Syria, he said, let me remind Hezekiah. Don't he pay no attention to what God is telling him. But see, what King of Syria forgot, he forgot God created him, Hezekiah, the situation and everything at hand.
That's right.
God is the sovereign God. He said, earth is what? His footstool. What was the song said? Lord, let thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven.
Amen.
How many believe in your situation that the will of heaven is being done in your situation?
Yeah.
See, this is how you got to be saying, Lord, let your will be done. Don't let my will be done. Because,
yeah.
See, if I listen to my will going to tell me the system says that their policies state this. The system says that the law says this. The system tells me that when your God tells you whatever he tells you in church, that now the law of the land will overrule what God said. And I say that's a lie.
Amen.
So here, King Assyria, he want to remind Hezekiah of some things.
Amen.
But in verse 11, he said, behold, you have heard what the king of Assyria have done to all the land. Now see, this is what they do, they tell you. Now remember, we don't want in this case. We won this one. We got that one. We got that one. Now what you gonna do coming up in here? See, that's how the enemy do.
That's right.
He'll try to tell you, don't come up against me. I'm too big for you.
That's right.
Don't come up against me. We already got this in place. You're not coming in. But behold, you have heard of what the king of Assyria have done to all the lands, devouring them to destruction.
Yes,
and shall you be delivered? That's what they tell you. Do you think you're going to be delivered? Do you think you're going to be delivered?
Amen.
Do you think you're going to be delivered? Let me tell y'all something. No matter what nobody tell me, I don't care. Now, I always say, God, you got my back. God, you got me. I don't care what they say. I don't care what report you give me. I don't care how many no's I get. I don't care how you shut the door in my face.
Yes, God.
I don't care what you say to me.
Yes, God.
All I say sometimes, I say, God, I'm just your humble, least little one.
Yes, God.
I'm just a child and a servant of the Lord. You know, somebody cussed me out real good last week. I mean, they cussed me real good. Bless the Lord. And I say, thank you. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
But they didn't know my anointing. They didn't know who I was. That's why you got to be careful. Who you talking to?
That's right.
Amen. But see, I went right on. Hallelujah. Because see, I know who got my back.
Amen.
Have the gods of the nations delivered them? The nations that my father destroyed. Now he goes on to name them. Gozan, Haran, Rapha, and the people of Eden who were in Tezzar. Where is the king of Hamath, the king of Arpad, the king of the city of Saharan, and the king of Hela, and of the king of Abba? He said, now where's all these people? See, you look at things sometimes, and then you'll be saying, uh-oh, let me rethink this thing. Let me go back and make another decision. Let me go back. Y'all know how we do. When we look at the thing and we look at the paperwork, you're sitting there looking at it in writing. But see, that's why the Bible said, whose report will you believe? Who you gonna believe? You gonna believe, I don't care what they put on paper. I don't care what it says. I have to believe my Bible. What did I say in 2017? What was we gonna stand on? We gonna stand on the word. Amen. We gonna believe what the word say. What we gonna do? I love the newsletter because it was talking about love. Let me tell you something. When you love people and forgive people and you let and shut your mouth and let God fight your battle, let me tell you something. The angels are released on your behalf.
Amen.
Oh my God.
Thank you,
Jesus. Okay. Thank you, Lord. So I want to tell you all, don't be discouraged in trusting God for help. Don't get disencouraged when you believe in God for help.
Yes, sir.
Now, if God done told you something and you know he spoke it to you and you know you felt that thing down in your innermost soul,
yes, God.
You go ahead and stand on that thing.
Yes, God. Yes, God.
He pointed out the in-depthness of other nations and God's against his military might. It was like having a big bullet tell you in so many ways he was gonna beat you down in front of your face. But see, you know what? That's okay. Cause my Bible tells me, hallelujah, that I ain't got to worry. You know, you can persecute me, you can say all you wanna say about me, but guess what? God gonna fight my battle.
Amen.
Cause my battle's already been won. Hallelujah. My circumstance, my situation, it's already taken care of.
Amen.
All
Amen.
That stuff that's back there behind me that you think is dead, that you think is gone, that the enemy done told you give up on, somebody I'll be saying this morning, I'm taking my stuff back. I want restoration. God redeemed my money's back to me. God, give me back my houses. Give me back my land. Give me back all my children. I want their inheritance. I want everything
Thank
back.
You.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Glory to
God.
See, you know, don't get in my face and tell me about your world. I want to hear about your God. I want to hear how you help things in the world. Because if you ain't telling me that you're standing on the scripture, and then don't tell me you're standing on the scripture, and then I see you out doing something else either. Don't tell me, because my Bible tell me bitter and sweet water can't come out the same citrus. Meaning you can't curse God today and then praise him tomorrow. You can't be in sin and then say you holy today. Hallelujah. Hezekiah turned to the Lord for help. Hezekiah, he turned to God. He turned to the one that he knew, hallelujah, that he was going to be steadfast. He was going to be unshakable. He wasn't going to move. He was not going to change his mind, because what the Bible said, he changed not.
Amen.
He's the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. He don't change.
Amen.
If he said he'd deliver you, he'd deliver you.
Yes, God.
If he said he'd heal you, he'll heal you.
Yes, God.
If he said it, I'm going to believe God.
Yes, God.
Y'all know, I tell you, I tell some people, I understand what David said when he said that I was young and now I'm old. I've never seen the righteous forsaken nor a seed begging bread. Let me tell you, I can look back on some things now and I can see, hallelujah, how God brought some things through. He gonna bring you through.
Amen.
You got an inheritance following you. You got some blessings that's ready to overtake you. You got some things, they just waiting for you to put that devil under your foot. He's waiting on you to take authority. We said this was going to be the year of the Holy Ghost. We said this was going to be the year of the power. Take back your power. Take it back. Take back your power. Take back your authority. Hallelujah. So many days to Resurrection Sunday. These next few days you ought to be fasting every Wednesday. Telling God, just like he got up out the grave, my situation is going to rise up and it's going to be blessed. God going to turn it around. I don't care what the papers say. I don't care what the people say when they call on the phone, but I know what the God of heaven said.
Amen.
And he said, I'm blessed and I'm not cursed. He said, I'm blessed in the sin. He said, I'm above and not beneath.
Amen.
You better know your word. Tell the devil, Hezekiah went. He went in and he took that message that they pulled tablets.
Amen.
And they had to burn the stuff back then. And they put it on tablets. And they take that to Hezekiah. He said, Lord, let me find your altar. And let me go spread this God? Are you talking to God?
Amen.
Are you telling Lord, do you see this?
Amen.
Lord, where is my loophole in this? God, how are you going to get up with this?
Hallelujah, Lord God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Don't send me no papers. I got the lawyer of lawyers.
Thank you, Lord God.
I got the one in the system that's above every system.
Amen.
Don't tell me what they're not going to give you. Don't tell me what the world not going to do.
Yes,
don't tell me who my healer is. I know who he is.
Yes, God. Yes, God.
He's the one that got up with all power in his hand. He's the one that gave you your authority when you accepted
glory,
him.
Glory, glory, God. Glory. Amen. Amen.
Y'all, I'm trying to get y'all to believe this thing. See, I don't want you to go out here. Oh, Lord. Woo. Let me tell y'all something. The enemy gonna come. And he gonna come like a flood. The word told you that. But he said when he come like a flood, what he gonna do? He gonna lift up a standard and he gonna flee. But see, this is the thing what happens. Let me just skip around for a little bit. Let me get this spirit. Of complacency. You know what? When you get a spirit, when the enemy come in your situation and you got a spirit of complacency, you know what you're going to do? You're going to press in or you're going to stop. And when you stop, the enemy will overtake you.
Amen.
And when the enemy overtake you, you don't know what's going to happen to you.
Amen.
I see some things going on with some people right now, and let me tell you, I'm going to tell you the truth.
Amen.
Brother Randolph, I'm going to tell you the truth. Sister Red, I'm going to tell you the truth. I'm going to tell you the truth. Hallelujah. I'm not going to wrestle on my bed. Asking God, did I do the right thing? Did I say the right thing? I don't want you to lose your soul. I don't want you to lose your mind. I don't want you to lose nothing because I didn't tell you what the Bible said. Because let me tell you, you cannot straddle the fence. You got to make up your mind and say,
hallelujah,
this day, who will I serve? You got to make your choice today. You got
to
be assured that you're going to serve him and him alone.
Amen.
Praise God. Y'all know I'm trying this morning. Bless the Lord.
Glory.
Bless the Lord. But sometimes we get in that self-satisfying state. I'm negligent, say it from
negligence.
Thank you, Lord. Or careless, especially in a relationship to one's personal situation. See, your personal situation, you got to trust God with that thing.
Amen.
You got to give it to God. When Hezekiah got that letter, when he got that message, praise God, that thing was personal. He didn't go to nobody else. He took it to the altar. He put it on the altar. He gave it to God. And he said, now God, he spread them tablets out on the altar. Praise God.
Mm.
See, you ought to be somewhere and you ought to be saying, Lord, I got this piece, but let me give it to God. I'm going to put this up. And what scripture go here? Okay, now when I talk to them, Lord, they're going to be talking right. If they ain't talking right, I'm going to say, excuse me very much. Somebody just walked in. Can I call you back?
Mm-hmm.
See, the Bible says, if you lack wisdom,
oh, glory,
let him ask God.
Hallelujah.
If you ain't asking God how to come up against these things, the enemy will get you complacent in your situation, and being complacent is a spirit. And when you get complacent, you detach. And when you detach, oppression and depression can set in.
Lord, thank you, Father. Mm. Thank you, Lord God.
And when them spirits set in,
oh, God.
Hallelujah.
Then you got to come back for deliverance.
Yes, God.
Praise the Lord.
Yes, God. Yes, God.
Let me tell you something. You cannot let your situation or your circumstances overtake you. When you say that you're going to do something for the Lord, let me tell you something. Pastor told me this morning, he said, honey, he said, I'm going to be in church. I told him, I said this, if it's you and me in them walls, I'm going to preach like I'm preaching now. Ain't going to change. If I got to preach to myself, I'm going to do what God told me to do.
Amen.
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 This is how you know. This is how you get delivered. You cannot become complacent in your situation, because it can, when you do, we too can become so complacent and neglectful as to how we live our lives. If we do not respond to God, then He will increase the pressure.
Yes, God.
And then
yes,
you'll be saying, Lord, why is it getting, it don't seem like it's getting no better.
Amen.
It don't seem like it's getting no better. But you know what you're not doing? You're not pressing in. You say, well, I done prayed, I don't know what to do. Press in. You pray in 10 minutes, pray 10 more minutes. You read your Bible in the morning, read it more like you eat. Breakfast, lunch, and dinner.
That's right.
He said He would keep your mind in perfect peace who stayed on Him.
That's right.
I ain't got time to think about nothing else.
That's right.
I can't think of, I don't want to hear your drama. I don't want to hear your stuff. I ain't got time for that. Well, all I got to hear is what God is saying, that He blessed my borders. He said that He promised that He would save my children. You know, I was like, praise the Lord, something happened last week. I had told the pastor, I said, God showed me something. And then sure enough, the next day around the same time, something happened. And he was like, he said, well, did you pray? I said, I prayed. I said, it could have been worse. I said, it could have been their life.
Amen.
Y'all better hear God up in here. You better hear God. Because He's trying to tell you something. He's trying to say, I need y'all to come to me.
Yes,
I need y'all to bring them situations.
Yes,
I need y'all to bring them circumstances.
Yes,
when y'all get those reports, I need y'all to bring them to me.
Yes, God.
And I need you to put them on the altar. And then I need you to wait to hear from me. And then if I don't move when you think I move, I want you to be still. Do you know how to be still? Y'all don't know how to be still because the world tells you you got to do something. You're busy doing what? Nothing.
Come on.
Busy doing nothing.
Breathe.
If I told y'all what my day consists of, sometimes y'all would be saying, no. And I never miss my wifely duties. Do I, Pastor?
No.
I cook, I clean, I still do my ministry, and I still do everything else I have to do. Because He has anointed me to do it. Because why? When you pray, He'll show you. Because y'all don't know how to be, the women, you got to know how to be a Proverbs 31 woman. You got to know how to pray for your children. You got to know how to work. The Bible says that a Proverbs 31 woman, she's working. She ain't looking for Mr. Do Right to give her this, that. Go make your own way. Then He give you somebody got more than you got.
Amen.
Oh, God, let me get back. Praise the Lord. Jesus, complacency can only be broken off our lives, hallelujah, this way, through walking in the Spirit. Let me tell y'all something. If you don't walk in the Spirit and you don't begin to bind and restrict your actions, every action got to glorify God. Everything you do got to glorify God. You know what? You are your friends, your brothers and sisters, your kids, everybody should be holding everybody accountable with your words, what you're saying, what you're doing. I thank God, hallelujah, for each and every one of you in here, because we should hold each other accountable with our words. We should be speaking blessings. We should be speaking deliverance.
Amen.
We should be speaking healing. We should be speaking that everything over these children, that they're going to be millionaires. They're going to be,
yeah,
that they're going to be CEOs.
Yeah.
That they're going to be all these great things, and they still going to know the Lord our,
yes,
God. They still going to be spirit-filled, blood-washed, hallelujah.
See,
we have to speak these things over them. I don't care what they're saying. I don't care what they're doing. I don't care how they're looking, how they're turning, everything. But me and Sister Brenna, we was talking about this, and you know what? And we said this, and Lord knows, Pastor, and then we was just saying, how many black millionaires do we know? I mean, that's close to us. One of her sons, he's really a millionaire.
Yeah.
I'm talking about a multimillionaire. And they grew up in the worst of situations. Worst of situations. But you know what? They was praying. They had them little corner churches. Y'all remember them little corner churches? And somebody, every time you get in trouble, you go to a little corner church and you go in there and just shout and praise the Lord and da 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 da, you know. But praise the Lord. But we thank God. Praise the Lord. You got to speak and pray and praise God over the things that you know, over these kids' life, over your life.
Amen.
What you speak today is going to happen tomorrow.
Yeah.
You might as well speak, I'm already delivered. You might as well speak that that situation is already taken care of. You might as well speak that thing already. Hallelujah. But don't let them spirits drag you down.
Yes, God.
You got to bring every thought on captivity. You got to submit everything, every word to God and casting it down. And we got to learn how to override our flesh and activate our faith.
Yes, God.
You
yes,
got to trust God.
Yes,
God. Do you trust him?
Yes.
Do you trust him?
Yes, God.
Do you really trust him?
Yes, God.
See, let me tell you, some people, I'm going to tell you, I tell people this anyway. If I vouch for you and I take my word, if I tell somebody they can count on you, praise the Lord, I want them to be able to count on you.
That's right.
Praise the Lord. Because, see, that's the kind of reputation that you should have in the spirit. Because, see, the way Hezekiah got his prayers answered, he honored God in his prayer. See, you got the power, people. You got the power. Somebody say, I got the power.
I got the power.
Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you,
Jesus.
Hallelujah. You got to acknowledge the truth about
God.
Hallelujah. You got to put that problem in the right perspective.
Yes, God.
Hallelujah. How do you see that problem? How do you see it? Do you see it, that problem defeating you? Or do you see yourself defeating that problem?
That's right. That's right.
What perspective? Didn't God say the first of the year that I don't forget my word? God gave me a word, I don't forget. He said he was going to give us a different perspective.
Amen.
I can't see it like the world see it.
Amen.
I can't go after it like the world go after it.
Amen.
I got to go after it like God said.
Glory to God.
Praise God. If I'm going to be blessed.
Yes.
If I'm going to do what God said do,
yes.
I got to go after it the way God said go after it.
Thank you, Lord God.
You got to see this problem in the right perspective.
Glory, glory, glory.
Hallelujah. Ask God. Y'all need to begin your everything to come in the mail. Everything that you can't handle, you need to be asking God. Look at this level. Look what these people say. And I know y'all asking God to look at them bills. Amen. that's just a given. Amen.
Hallelujah.
I know you putting them bills on the altar and saying, okay,
yes,
God,
yes,
you
God.
Handle this.
Yes, God.
Thank you, Lord. And Pastor know this too. They've been sending me letters for about 4 or 5 years trying to tell me, they're trying to give me real estate back. Praise the Lord. I be saying, Lord, I can't go there. You know, I know when my season and my time. See, this is the thing. You got to know when your season. You got to know when your time is done. Amen. You can't go back and wake up no old devils.
Uh-huh.
Somebody didn't get that.
I got that.
Okay. Okay. Praise God. Amen. So praise the Lord. So you got to look and see what God is saying to you. Acknowledge the truth about the situation. Now I want you to move in faith. Oh God, I feel the Holy Ghost up in here. But acknowledge the truth. Be truthful, okay?
Yes, God.
Now these people say that doesn't gonna happen. Okay, God. Now I'm talking to you. And they saying this, that, and other. Okay, now God, but now your word said, and you said now you're a supernatural God, and I need supernatural intervention and okay, now I need a miracle. A miracle is something that man cannot explain. What's possible with God is impossible with man. All right, come on now. Somebody come on, have an honest conversation with God. Now, Lord, I can't do no more now. I don't even know how to talk to you. They're talking over my head. Okay, they're trying to use some of them words that, you know, I didn't get there, okay? Come on, y'all. Just tell the truth. Amen? I'm not no attorney. Amen? I'm not no CEO. I can't always go grab pastor or somebody else. No, I got to talk to God for myself about this thing. I ain't got to. Sometimes I can't get to nobody.
Amen.
Come on, be truthful. Tell God you can't fight the system. You can't fight it.
Praise the Lord.
I want you to be truthful about that thing. And then, hallelujah, and this is the thing. It's where you don't let complacency sit in.
Amen.
This is where you don't come detached and become tired and grow weary in that thing. Let me tell you, we could grow weary and tired, but that's why you always got to stir yourself up in the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
That's why you got to have the power of God.
Yes.
That's why I say, if don't nobody come in here ready to praise him, I can get myself already fired up. I can think about the goodness of God and what he's done for me. I can think about yesterday, and I can look at me right now. Y'all know that song? I love it, I love it, I love it, for Shirley Caesar. She said, and they took it, and they said, I made it. Uh-huh. Shirley Caesar hit him with a $5 million lawsuit. Y'all right?
Amen.
She right. That's a song.
That's right.
And then they're going to take it and gyrate to it. You can't take what's holy and desecrate it for the devil.
That's right.
And you got all kind of folks twerking and
that's right.
And stuff. And then you think she happy to see that when she was trying to give honor to Amen. God.
Amen.
And then they on the internet looking like boo-boo the... Come on, them devils. Gonna take what God did. And then all of a sudden they're gonna be out there just... When I saw she put that lawsuit on, I said, praise God.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. I hope she get every penny of it.
Amen.
Can't take what belongs to God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Y'all be messing with folks. People better know who they messing with. They say, oh, Mother Shirley, come on and sing. When we have all of that, come on, do your Christian song. We're going to let you shout this one song on stage. And she get out there and bring in the anointing. Oh, we can do this to her. You forget she served the Most High God.
That's right.
Y'all better be careful.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Lord Jesus. I told the Lord I didn't have nothing to say this morning. Bless the Lord. But see, this is where, y'all, we can't be complacent. And y'all got to stand up for something. This is why you got to take everything to God. I'm sure she prayed about what to do. Now, let me tell you something. The Assyrians, they were tough. They defeated a lot of people. And see, sometimes these things in our life, you know, we have to ask for God's help and his deliverance. Praise God. Hallelujah. Sometimes, now, let me tell y'all something. And I want to just be honest, though. And I, you know, and I even tell y'all about myself, because sometimes, you know, things get so bad, I got to go get me a bowl of ice cream, and I don't even like ice cream. I said, Lord, you know, but you can't let things, and then I had to put it down. I had said, no, no. Anything that's going to take my mindset, I don't want to get satisfied my flesh like that so much that I can't believe God. I know y'all said, well, maybe that's too radical. Well, it may be. But see, let me tell y'all something. Y'all can't go, and you know, some Christians, they'll tell me, well, Pastor, I'm just going to have a glass of wine. No, I can't do that because I got to be sober-minded. Because if I'm sober-minded, I can't let the enemy come in, okay? Now, if God told you you can do that, you go ahead. I'm just telling you what I can't do. Now, listen, you can't use stuff as a crutch when you're going through this. Because, see, then you're still at a standstill. You're
Amen.
Still letting the enemy come in, and then God can't move. That's why I keep saying you got to keep your mind. Let this mind be in you that was also in Christ Jesus. See, God is trying to take y'all somewhere because, see, it's going to take you getting somewhere on the altar with them situations for God to work it out. See, it's going to take a little bit more pressing in because, see, this is what I was saying, we were saying on the prayer line. See, you can get a blessing. You can get a trickle of a blessing. God can move in some areas, but then all of a sudden, you know, you didn't get the whole enchilada. You didn't get the whole blessing. And then all of a sudden the devil done deceive you because you think, oh, I got it now. You better stay humble. You better walk in the spirit. You ain't there yet. You still got some mountains to climb.
Amen.
You still got to stay on this on the path of righteousness
yes,
for
yes,
his
yes,
name's
yes,
sake.
Yes,
you still got to keep that attitude right.
Yes.
You still got to keep that flesh under subjection.
Glory.
You still got to be lined up with the word of God. Because
Amen.
Let me tell you, the Lord giveth and the Lord taketh
Amen.
Away. I'm trying to help you because God want to bless somebody today.
Amen.
And he got more for you. But he wants you to press in. And you said, well, Pastor, how can I press in anymore? How can I press in anymore? I told you, pray some more. Read the word some more.
Amen.
Study some more.
Hallelujah.
Go get you a commentary and read it some more. You know, I found the, I be looking for some spiritual all the time. And I think Minister Reddy had given some to Pastor. And Lord have mercy, we looked in the thing and there was some a whole prayer at the bottom of the box. And we read it, bless the Lord. But it was an answer for that day.
Hallelujah.
For that day. It was
Glory
an answer
God.
For that day.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. At the appointed time. So you better be looking and seeking. See, it said, when you seek me early in the morning,
Glory.
Are you seeking him? What's the first thing you do in the morning?
Right.
What's the first thing you do before you go to bed at night?
Right.
What's the first thing? What's the last thing?
Right.
See, I may not get up in the morning, so the last thing I got to do, me and Jesus got to have a little talk.
Amen.
When I get up in the morning, I got to have a little talk with Jesus,
yes.
and I got to tell him about my day, because see, I don't know what I'm going to run into.
Yes.
I don't know what devil's been loose, so I got to make sure that the ministering angels are going to go I got to stand still and see this thing come to pass.
Amen.
Because I'm standing for some people in here, even people that you don't see. I'm praying. And you know, Pastor says it there. I said, I don't care. I said, the Bible tell me if I pray in my closet, he'll reward me openly. I don't care where you at. I don't care where you going. Praise God. If I pray, if I intercede and you make it in the kingdom and you're a part of the kingdom of God, praise God, he answered my prayer.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Praise God. We almost done here. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Kings, 2 Kings chapter 9. Hallelujah. Let me tell you how God blessed. Praise God. Let's go to 2 Kings chapter 19, verse 20. Somebody read it for me. Praise the Lord. 2 Kings chapter 19, verse 20 through 29.
And Isaiah, the son of Amoz, sent to Hezekiah, saying, so says Jehovah, the God of Israel, I have heard that which you have prayed to me regarding Sennacherib, the king of Assyria. This is the word that Jehovah spoke concerning him. The virgin daughter of Zion has despised you and laughed you to scorn. The daughter of Jerusalem has shaken her head behind you. Whom have you reproached and reviled? Against whom have you lifted up a voice? Yea, you have lifted up your eyes on high, even against the Holy One of Israel.
See, let me tell you something. Y'all better be careful. Don't worry about people saying nothing. When God done spoke, praise the Lord, and he done spoke that thing, it's okay. It's well with you. You don't even have to worry about it. What, you don't even have to defend yourself. Because, see, God had already spoke deliverance to them. He already knew what was going to happen. Praise the Lord. He said, I heard your prayer. Hallelujah. So God promised to defend them. Do y'all believe God going to defend you in every situation? Do you believe? See, I just believe God got my back.
Yes.
I remember when I was like 3-4 years old, my daddy sent me, he just told me, he said, I remember my little red rocking chair. And I remember him sitting me down and he told me, he said, just don't play with God and God will always take care of you. He said, and he told me, he said, just always pray. That has stayed with me all my life. That's why I teach my grandkids. Yes, Jesus loved me. He got the whole wide world. I tell Courtney, he got you in his hand. I tell my daughter, I said, put spiritual things in her spirit. Because when she's a teenager and she don't want to come talk to me or you, what's going to come back to her? That's that song that she used to sing, the word of God. It's going to come back to her. You know, she was in here saying she went home and she liked that song awesome so much. My God is awesome. You know what? And I just played it for her and I let her play it all the way home. I sent it to Chantal. I said, let her learn that song. Let her play it. Let her sing it. Because she will know all the days of her life that her God is an awesome God. Amen.
Amen.
Praise God. Amen. So we're going to finish up. Praise the Lord. Y'all blessed this morning.
Amen.
Hallelujah. 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 Come on, y'all. Let's read the end. Let's get the last 32 through 35 and let's see how he blessed them. Praise the Lord. 32, chapter 19, verse 32 through 35. Hallelujah. How he blessed them. Hallelujah.
Therefore, thus saith the Lord concerning the king of Assyria, he shall not come into this city, nor shoot an arrow there, nor come before it with a shield, nor cast.
Hold on one sec. Now see, he said he ain't even gonna let the enemy shoot an arrow. He can't even come now your dwelling no more. When God bless you, that's it. When God bless you, the devil can't come no more. When it's been stamped and sealed, it's done. It's done.
Amen.
Y'all hear me? It's done.
Amen.
So it don't know where. Go ahead.
Okay. And then, nor shoot an arrow there, nor come before it with a shield, nor cast a bank against it. By the way that he came, by the same shall he return, and shall not come into this city, saith the Lord. For I will defend this city to save it for my own sake and for my servant David's sake.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. See, he gonna save your city. He gonna save your house. He gonna say that you're out there circumstances, all that situation. Because see, God done spoke. He done prophesied. Now let me tell you something. This morning, I got one more little bit here for y'all. And then we gonna do something real different here. Okay. Let me tell y'all something. And y'all, I want y'all to go home and I want y'all to read this because I know time and I know everybody getting restless, praise the Lord. But listen, in Hebrews chapter 6, verse 12, it says, so that you may not be sluggish, but imitators of those who through faith and patience inherit the promise. Y'all need to be watching people who walk in that life, standing in faith, believing and trusting God. Amen. Y'all need to get around some people. When we had the, I thank God for all the people that came to the new members class last week. It was a blessing because I believe that everybody was renewed. I know the time went back, but whatever, but you know what? It's gonna be a blessing from henceforth on, praise the Lord. But let me tell you something, we have the power today to change everything. We have the power. And if y'all read in Acts chapter 3, when Jesus passed by that man that needed healing, he didn't pray for him. He just told him. He just lifted him up and the man began to walk. Y'all know that Acts, in the book of Acts, chapter 3, 1 through 8? Because Peter, he already had the authority and the power in him. Y'all already got the power and the authority in you. I know you're anointed.
Amen.
Brother Max, I know you're anointed. Brother Randolph, I know you're anointed. Sister Monique, Tony, I know y'all anointed. Brother Stevie, you anointed. Amen. You anointed. Brother Elijah, Jordan, Jaden, you anointed. Xavier, you anointed. You already got the Holy Spirit, whether your tongues are manifested or not. I believe that the power of the Holy Ghost, and I believe in God one day, that the tongues gonna come up in here like crazy. Tanya, yeah, I know you already got your tongues. I know you just don't use them. Thank you, Jesus. Come on now.
Amen.
Come on.
Amen.
Come on, Johnny. You know you got it. Thank you, Lord. I heard it with my own ears.
Amen.
Y'all got the power. You're not gonna let the enemy give you the wrong perspective on what you're dealing with.
Yes.
Come on now. Thank you, Lord. I'm going to do this. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. See, when Pastor sang the song, it's intentional. I believe it's intentional this morning because God want to be intentional in your situation. He want to go right and be specific to the point and to where he needs to go. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father God. Father, I thank you today, Lord God. Lord, I thank you, Lord God, that you anoint us, Lord God, to pray. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Let me say this before I close out. Hallelujah. I want to say these two things. Let me tell you, I believe that this time, this year, hallelujah, I believe each and every one of you, hallelujah, I want you all to begin to pray. Hallelujah, not pray at church, not pray on the prayer line, but I want you to pray in your own prayer closet. And I want you to begin to pray, and I want you to begin to pray and ask God this, Lord, let me see the fruits of my prayers. Let me see what I pray come to pass. This is what I want to do. Yes. This is what I want you to see, because Hezekiah went to God. Let me tell you something. Wednesday, I was very, very, very busy. And Sister Tawana made an error, and she got her times mixed up. But I had given my word that I was going to go to the thing. But see, yet while I was keeping my word, and I said, okay, God, I'm going to do this. Yet while I was doing that, God was still blessing me. Was he not?
Amen.
And even before, when I got the phone call, I didn't even answer the call. I said, I'll just let it go to the voicemail. But see, I tell you this. You cannot beat God. When you take care of God's least little one,
Amen.
What you do for these children, what you do for the ministry, what you lend of your gifts and your talents to God,
Amen.
He will make up for it. I feel unwanted. He will make up for it.
Amen.
I tell you, I could not have believed. I said, oh God, what did I do now? You know, I said, but bless the Lord. I'm always praying, bless the Lord. All right now. I just have to get my stance ready. Come on. But praise the Lord. It was a good thing. Amen. Thank you, Father. Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord God, I thank you today, Lord God, that you're raising up, Lord God, the people in the house of Habakkuk to a new level of prayer, Lord God.
Amen, amen.
To a new pressing in, Lord God.
Amen.
I thank you, Lord God, that you're giving them new perspectives, Lord God, on their situations. And Lord God, on how, Lord God, that you are turned, you have spoken over their situations,
yes,
over
God.
Their circumstances, Lord God, and how you're getting ready to redeem and restore, Lord God.
Yes,
and you're
God.
Getting ready to bless them, Lord God, even more than they can even understand where you're getting ready to take them, God. Lord, I thank you today, Lord God. Lord, that you bless them, Lord God.
Yes,
that they
Lord.
Hear you in their situation. Oh, God, oh, God, oh, God, bless
yes,
them.
God.
Oh, God, put a fervor, a thirst, a hunger in them, Lord God, to seek you, to pray like never before. Lord God, to get in your word, Lord God, like never
yes.
before, Lord God. Lord, shake them in their house, Lord God.
Yes.
Let the Holy Ghost come up on them, Lord God, no matter wherever they are, Lord God. Let the spirit of the living God, Lord God, just come upon them. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name, we thank you for the power of the Holy Ghost, Lord
yes.
God, rising up on the inside of them, Lord God, causing them to triumph and be successful in every
yes.
place in the mighty name of Jesus. And we give you glory, honor, and praise. And it is in the name of Jesus that we pray. Amen.